गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन।
सो दिस इज द नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम, दैट इज x² / dx माइनस ऑफ x³ + xy² (dy) = 0। सो बिफोर गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन दिस प्रॉब्लम यू नीड टू नो दिस प्रोसीजर। व्हाट इज केस 3? ऑलरेडी वी कंप्लीटेड केस 1 एंड केस 2 टू फाइंड इंटीग्रेटिंग फैक्टर ऑफ ए नॉन एक्जैक्ट डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन। इफ द गिवन डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन इज नॉट एक्जैक्ट देन वी हैव टू फाइंड इंटीग्रेटिंग फैक्टर। Then after we have to multiply the integrating factor with the given differential equation, then the given differential equation will become exact. Then after we have to proceed like general solution form, right? So see the procedure, case 3. Integrating factor will be here 1/n² (n1). We have to multiply this integrating factor with the given differential equation. Then the given differential equation will become m1 dx + n1 dy (0), right? (0). If now we have to find dou m1 by dou y, both are equal, then it is an exact. If it is an exact differential equation, then we have to find general solution. That is integral m1 dx + integral m1 dy (c). Okay. For each and every problem, not each and every problem, some problems will come in all the methods, but we have to choose which method is suitable for the given differential equation. Okay. Whether it is in case 1 or case 2 or case 3 or case 4, you have to apply the case to the given differential equation. Okay, if you observe here n is small and n is greater, you can use 1/n (dou m/dou x) - dou m/dou y, that also. If you use that also, maybe you will get the same solution. Okay, but yes, this problem will be in the form case 3, 1/n² - ny. So before going to start this problem, listen what we have to do first step. First of all, we have to compare this equation with m dx + n dy (0), where m is nothing but this and n is nothing but this. Then you have to find dou m by dou y (dou m by dou x). If both are equal, then we have to find directly general solution. If both are not equal, then we have to find integrating factor. We have to multiply the integrating factor with the given differential equation. Then after we have to solve like general solution form. Okay, general solution is how? Integral m1 dx + n1 dy. Here in this, y should be constant here. Terms not contains x. Means terms only contains y. Means independent of x. You should not take x term and combination of x and y terms here. When you are doing in integration, we have to consider y as constant, right? Okay, this is the procedure to solve case 3, non-exact differential equation. So, coming to the problem. Now, let integration number come. So, equation 1 is in the form of m dx + n dy. Equation 1 is in the form of m dx + n dy. So where m is equal to x²y, then we have to find dou m/dou y. With respect to y, partial derivative is x should be constant here, x² (1), that is x². Okay. Now n is equal to -(x³ + xy²). So this we have to do with respect to x, that is dou m/dou x. Okay, with respect to x means y should be constant. Here it is 3x² and then here it is y². For x it is 1. So minus of 3x² + y². So clearly dou m/dou y is not equal to dou n/dou x. Both are not equal means equation 1 is not an exact differential equation. Therefore, equation 1 is not an exact differential equation. So, if here it is not an exact differential equation, we have to find integrating factor. Here the integrating factor is of the form 1/mx + ny. Means with m we have to multiply with x, with m we have to multiply with y, then after we have to add 1 by, so m is nothing but x square by into x minus of x cube plus xy square into y. Okay, then integrating factor is equal to 1 by x into x square is x cube y minus into plus minus x cube by minus x cube by minus into plus minus x into y square into y is y cube minus x y cube. Right? These two are cancelled. Now integrating factor will be minus 1 by x y cube. Now we have to multiply this integrating factor with the given differential equation. Multiply 1 with integrating factor. Multiply 1 with integrating factor. So then minus 1 by x y cube into x square y into dx minus into minus plus 1 by x y cube into x cube plus y square into dy, that is equal to 3. Right. Now multiply with this side. Here x and x will be cancelled. So minus x in the numerator, y y will be cancelled, y square in the denominator into dx plus x x will be cancelled, x square in the numerator, y cube in the denominator plus x x cancel means y square cancel, 1 by y in the denominator, y in the denominator. Equal to 0. Now if you observe, it is in the form of m1 dx plus n1 dy. This is equation 2. Equation 2 is in the form of, so like this here now, equation 2 is in the form of m1 dx plus n1 dy. That is equal to 0. Okay, where m1 is nothing but this term, that is minus x by y square. N1 is nothing but this total term, x square by y cube plus 1 by y. Right, 1 by y. Now we have to find dou this term, dou m1 by dou y, dou n1 by dou x. If both are equal, then that is an exact. Now we have to find dou m1 by dou y is equal to dou by dou y of minus x into y power of minus 2. This 1 by y square can be written as y power of minus 2. So with respect to y, means x should be constant, nx to the power of n minus 1, that is 2x by y cube. That is what dou m1 by dou y. Now dou n1 by dou x, that is dou by dou x of n1. N1 is nothing but this x square by y cube plus 1 by y. With respect to x, this y term should be constant. Here x square is 2x by y cube plus 0. So dou n1 by dou x is equal to 2x by y cube. Clearly, these two are equal. Therefore, equation 2 is an exact differential equation. Okay. So, clearly, dou m1 by dou y is equal to dou n1 by dou x is equal to 2x by y cube. 2x by y cube. So therefore, equation 2 is an exact, equation 2 is an exact, so it is an exact differential equation. We have a procedure to find general solution of a differential equation. Therefore, general solution of a differential equation 2 is integration of m1 is nothing but minus x by y squared into dx, here y should be 1, plus integration of only terms satisfied. See, if you observe in n1, this both are combination of x and y, so that you have to take only one term, that is 1 by y, dy is equal to c. Okay, so here y is constant means for only x, we have to do integration, that is 1 by y squared. So integration of x is x square by 2, right? So here it is plus ln of, sorry, log of y is equal to c. So here it is minus x square by 2 y square plus log of y is equal to c. Is the general solution of a equivalent differential equation is the required general solution of a equivalent differential equation. Solution of a given differential equation. Okay, I hope all you understand. This is the procedure to solve a given non-exact differential equation by using the integrating factor 1 by mx plus e n y. Okay.